guys miss me? I think you may have missed me. What's going on? It's Stephanie Adams with SOS Solutions, and I know I've been gone for a little while. I'm crazy busy. You guys are really engaging with me and interacting with me, and I've been doing a lot of work for people, but I wanted to pop in here because I want to remind you that I'm here to help with your financial concerns and your credit concerns. And I've seen a few things, and I'm always learning. So seriously, I have a huge law library over here. So I'm constantly learning, and I learned something. I think I had already known it, but I've learned something that just might help you with getting a few more deletions on your credit report. And it has to do with when the bureaus actually respond to something that's been sent into them with an update to the report. So maybe not a deletion, but an update. So you guys stay tuned because this is gonna be really, really quick, but I wanna give you something that you should take a look at, okay? Okay, so I think I have this set up correctly. I am so not computer literate, but this is really important, so I really wanna show you guys this. This is an Experian credit report. At least this is their layout direct from Experian. So when you write to a credit bureau, they are supposed to send you back your full consumer profile. And Experian, when they do this, they send you an before shot and then an after shot of what the credit report looked like. I think I have secured this pretty well. Okay, so I want you guys to just take a look. You can see right here that it says before the dispute, okay? So you can see the date was, it claims the date open was 2015, and it was first reported in October of 2015. What I really want you guys to take a look at is the payment history right here. So you have a complete payment history since it was opened in 2015. Now, one of the keys to charge off removals is making sure that this comment field says that the account is disputed. So that's good. We're not gonna be able to use that argument for this one, but I will show you what we may be able to use. So just pay attention to what this looks like right here. It's different. See, what they did here, I hope you guys can see that clearly. What they did here was they completely removed all of the positive payment history on this account. Now, let me go back up so you can see it again. This is the full payment history, right? This is the new payment history that they updated. And what else you can see is it says the date open was May of 2015 and first reported August of 2018. That data is inaccurate. It was first opened in May 2015 and first reported in October 2015, according to their own records. And when they went to update it, they changed it. Now, why is this important? Hold on one second and I'll let you know. The Fair Credit Reporting Act says that information on a credit report has to be timely, verifiable, and accurate. Also, the Fair Credit Act was designed because they needed to make sure that your credit was it was accurate, because accuracy is obviously a big deal, as well as complete and fair. It's called the Fair Credit Act. So complete and fair. So what they did when they removed the entire payment history from this account and then created false data to say that it hadn't reported, it had only reported since October, which obviously was wrong from their previous reporting. What they did was they now made it inaccurate, incomplete, and it's no longer fair because they took away all of this person's positivity before the account was charged off. So what do you do about this? You write exactly that in a letter. It's not a template. You have to explain why it's inaccurate. The time is absolutely wrong on it because they deleted their own payment history. So it's wrong. So you have to find those errors. And sometimes they're not going to show up in the very beginning of this process. And oftentimes it does take a few months for these bureaus or these creditors as well to truly hang themselves. And a lot of times they get away with it because consumers have no idea what they're looking for on a credit report. So I hope this helps. My letter will be going out for my client about this, which will absolutely prove her case that what they did to her was wrong. This actually did drop her credit score. She is trying to buy a house, so now she has damages. So if she decides, you know what, because this creditor incorrectly updated my credit report, she may be able to now take this creditor to court and have the whole thing removed and potentially sue for damages. So I hope it doesn't have to go that far. I hope they see the error of their ways and they really just delete the entire account now. But these are the kinds of things that you can look at to be able to fight back against those bureaus. So I hope you guys learned something new. I'm so sorry I've been gone for so long. Make sure that you're subscribing so that you do catch me when I am here. And I promise I will be back a lot more frequently for you guys. And as I learn, you'll be learning too. So, all right, guys, make sure you reach out with any questions that you have, and we will talk again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.